Ever wish you could get a little help with your golf game? Maybe some personalized coaching and tips? That's the premise behind this new gadget. It's the Zepp Golf Tracker. I'm Erin for Best Buy Canada's blog, and I had a chance to spend a few rounds with this device to test it and provide this review.
Zepp 2 is a small golf sensor and movement tracker that's about the size of a loonie and about as thick as your pinky. It fits into a small bracket with a clip and slides onto your golf glove. Once activated, it'll track a number of stats: club speed, club plane on your downswing, hand plane, backswing position, tempo, and hip rotation. It's also got 3D analysis and video analysis capabilities built in.
Getting this device set up and using it wasn't as straightforward as I'd hoped. It comes with virtually no instructions, except for a one-page pamphlet that tells you to charge the tracker fully, then push and hold the button for 4 seconds to turn it on. From there, you're supposed to download the free app and follow the prompts to set up your account. With that done, you'll slide the sensor onto its clip-on mount and wear it on your golf glove. That's it. I thought I had it figured out, but I couldn't get the device to begin tracking my round when I activated it on the course.
Inside the app, there are several tabs. You can see them there at the bottom. There's Smart Coach, Training, Record, Feed, and Profile. Standing on the first tee, I was trying to figure out how to get things started. Somewhat unnaturally, choosing Record is what actually lets you score your round. Next up, I chose the more helpfully labeled Play tab, but then wasn't quite sure where to click next to advance and begin the round. So I chose Scorecard, and then thought I was ready. Next, the app didn't recognize the course I was playing at. It was a private course, but even so, it kept geolocating me at the correct location, but it had the course under a different name. Thinking maybe it was a clerical error, I just started playing, but the Zepp wasn't tracking. I was just seeing a grid with a whole bunch of horizontal lines through it. Turns out when you get ready to play golf, you'll need to push and hold the power button for 4 seconds, then you'll need to go into the app and touch the My Sensor button. It's up in the top corner and it's kind of shaped like a coffee bean. Touch that, then follow the instructions to connect your tracker via Bluetooth. If the tracker's not connected, no data is going to be saved from your round. It would be nice to have known that up front. The next issue I dealt with, the scorecard function didn't have course data already available like a lot of other golf apps I've tried, so that's why I was seeing those horizontal lines. I needed to score my round manually, inputting the par for each hole, then adding my score. As a result, using the sensor didn't feel seamless, it felt like it was constantly interrupting my round. After playing about 4 holes, I put the Zepp 2 away, vowing to learn more about it before my next game.
The second round I played with the Zepp 2 tracker, I was determined to be better prepared. I brought the tracker out on the driving range and selected the driving range option when I chose my course, which again wasn't recognized or being populated by the system. And by the way, a later check on about a dozen golf courses in the city of Calgary shows that less than half of the courses pop up under their proper name, which is a bit frustrating. So I took about 25 or 30 swings on the golf course driving range, thinking I'd have the data to look over later, but when I went to finish my range training and begin the round, I found I couldn't advance to score the round without deleting all my data. So as a result, all that training data was lost. I tried to use the tracker to score a third round, and by now I was mastering the device. So here's what to do.
Step 1, choose your course on the map. Step 2, push and hold the button on the tracker for 4 seconds to turn it on. Wait for the light to come on. Step 3, go to the Zepp app and click that coffee bean button, which should by now be blinking, or it may stay solid if it takes you a second to get there. Step 4, calibrate the tracker by clicking the calibrate button in the app. Step 5, return to the previous screen and choose play. Step 6, choose scorecard in the app.
Yet again, my chosen course had no data in the scorecard, so I had to score it manually. And it was here I gave up on Zepp on the third tee, and here's why. While I do love my gadgets and technology, I get out on the golf course for fresh air, sunshine, or to be with friends or my husband for a few hours of distraction. Constantly needing to input the data into my phone was tedious. I'd rather leave my phone in the cart and enjoy the game. If this device was easier to figure out and it was easier to use and it tracked things more automatically and I could just set it and forget it, as George Foreman used to say, it would be great. But in my opinion, the device requires too much handling and too much focus.
When I got back home, I figured I'd go through my data and see what it told me. Once again, I was left mystified by this device. I couldn't figure out how to find my last round's data. I clicked all over the app before finally realizing it's stored in the calendar function. To get there, you'll need to first go to the record screen, then you click into the calendar at the top right, and you can choose the tab labeled round, and it'll display your recent round information. And here is another thing I wasn't personally fond of with this device. What the heck to do with that data? While I did get some stats from the Zepp 2, as a novice golfer, I'm not really sure what to do with the scores. My swing score is 71, but 71 what? There's no legend or explanation in the app to tell me. My club plane consistency is 77%, yet I don't know what that tells me about my game or how I'm hitting the ball. This leads me to the real issue here. Who is the Zepp 2 Golf really for? As far as I can see, it would be most useful used by a golf pro in a lesson situation where the data can be collected, verified by the pro in person, and then explained. Alternately, this device might be helpful to a seasoned, experienced golfer who obsesses over all the details and is really trying to get better or break 80. Newbies or novices or those who aren't into the physics of the game yet are going to be frustrated and disappointed.
I do love my stats and I'd love to get better at the game of golf, but for me personally, this isn't the way I'm going to do it. This device is difficult to learn. It's missing a lot of course data in both Canada and California, the other spot I tried it in. And to me, it takes away from the round if you're constantly fussing with it. And if you're not checking and fussing, you're probably not going to get any stats. In my opinion, save your money for a few hours of lessons with a golf pro instead. If you want to read more about the Zepp Golf Tracker, there's a full blog online at blog.bestbuy.ca. You can head over there, check it out, ask me any questions you have either there on the blog or of course here on the YouTube channel as well. If you like this video and found it helpful, please hit that like button and consider subscribing. Since it helps me keep making more videos, I hope you all can watch and enjoy. I'm Erin. You can catch me on Twitter or Instagram. Until the next time, I'm at ErinLYYC.